everybody, and welcome back to Premiere Gal. If you guys are new here, consider subscribing and hitting that notification bell so you're notified when I make new video editing and production tutorials on this channel. So a lot of you guys have requested an After Effects beginner's course or a tutorial that will give you guys the basics. And After Effects is such a big software. There's so many things that you can do with it. It's Adobe's big effects software engine. And so the difference between Premiere Pro and After Effects is that Premiere Pro is more like a hub. It's where you're building an entire story, right? And After Effects is used to create different compositions, parts of the final video that you'll build in Premiere Pro. So for example, if you want to create some cool 3D animating text, you would create a composition in After Effects, and then you would pull that composition into Premiere Pro, and it's one part of the entire video that you're building in Premiere Pro. So I use After Effects all the time. I'm the Premiere Gal, as a lot of you guys know me as, but I also create lots of tutorials in After Effects, Adobe Audition, Photoshop, and everything, because the truth is you need to use all of these Adobe Creative Cloud apps to produce your video if you use the Creative Cloud video software. So in this tutorial, I'm basically just gonna give you an overview of all the tools in After Effects that you need to know about. And I'm gonna do a little demo of how to create a cinemagraph in After Effects, because I always think it's good to have something practical that you guys can follow along and show you how to do something concrete, and it'll help you understand how to use the tools better. So let's jump into After Effects and let's get started.
By default, when you open up Adobe After Effects, you will get a start window. Just click on a new project and it will default to an untitled project. To save it, just go to File, Save As, and then save as again, and save it to your project folder. I'll give it a name, After Effects Demo. Now you can see that the project has its new name up at the top. Now it's time to import any assets that you might use in your project, such as videos, music, photos, Illustrator, or even Photoshop files. There are multiple ways that you can import your assets. You can go to File and Import, or you can just hit Command-I or Control-I on a PC to open up the import dialog box. Another way to import is just by dragging the files directly into your project panel from your folder. It's really easy to do. But my favorite way to import is just to double-click in the project panel here, and it opens up the import file dialog box. So here you can import pretty much any type of file, and I'm going to import a video file and a photo file. These files I got from Envato Elements, where you can download unlimited photo, stock video, video templates, and design assets for as low as $16.50 per month. So once you have all of your files inside of the project window here, you can also organize them. You can create folders for each category of asset if you like. So let's go ahead and click on this folder icon and let's create a new folder for video. And let's also create another folder for photos. Then you can drag each type of file into the corresponding folder. I'd also recommend creating a folder for compositions, which brings us to the next topic, how to set up your first composition. If you're a user of Premiere Pro, a composition is like your sequence, your timeline. So just click on this icon here and this will enable you to create your first composition. I'm going to choose a composition dimension here in this dialog box of 1920 by 1080, which is HD, and 30 frames per second. You can also choose the default background color as well. Another way to create a composition is simply by right-clicking on any asset from your project panel. For example, if you want to add a video to a composition, you can right-click on the video clip from the project panel and select New Comp from Selection. You will see that we now have a new composition here. And it also gave the comp the name of the asset itself. So if you select this comp and you hit enter, you can rename it to anything that you want. The same works for any asset you choose here in the project panel. Just hit enter and you can rename it to anything that you want. So I'm going to call this composition comp 1. By doing it this way, it'll also make this composition the exact duration of the video clip itself. So if you need to change the duration of your composition, just right click on the comp tab here and select Composition Settings. And here you can type in a new time code next to duration. So if you want it to be 10 seconds, we can just replace this to be 10. And so now I'm going to illustrate how to create a cinemagraph in this demo to give you an introduction to adding assets to your comp, how to move layers, how to create masks, how to create stills from your video, add effects, and animate layers. And lastly, I'll show you approaches to exporting your final effect. So what is a cinemagraph? Well, a cinemagraph is a type of GIF. It's a looping piece of movement, but it only isolates a portion of movement in the image. So for example, with this video clip here, if I hit the space bar, you can see it's a shot of tea being poured. And what we can do is we can freeze the background and just isolate the movement of the tea pouring out of the spout. So here's a composition with the final product in it. And you can see that we are able to achieve the effect where the teapot is frozen as well as the background and just the tea is moving. So the first step is to isolate just the portion of the clip we want to create the cinemagraph from. So to do that, we need to scrub through and find a moment of the shot, about a second or so, where the tea spout is moving at a minimum. We don't want too much movement happening, or else it'll be too noticeable when we create the mask later on, and you will see. So once you find this moment here, I think that this part is the stillest out of all portions. What we can do is we can pull the layer back here to meet this new point. And then we can move the entire layer to the beginning of the comp so it starts at this new point. Then we can move this handle here to end at the moment we want it to loop. And this handle, you will see that there's two of them here. This is our work area. And if we hit the space bar to play it back, it's only looping that 1 second that we isolated in this work area. And the reason for that is if you go to preview and you see this loop button here is turned on. If you turn that off, you will play it back and you will only see it play once. So if we turn that back on, it is looping again. And we want this to be looping on because GIFs are looping in movement. So it's easier to see how it looks in the final product if that is turned on. So we have our background video in the shot, but now we need to make a still image of the shot, which will be placed in our background below this layer. And then I will show you how to create a mask. So first, let's scrub the playhead to the very beginning of the video clip. And if you toggle down, you will find transform tools. So you can change the scale of the clip using this control. You can also change the video's position if you move the X coordinate or the Y coordinate. You can also adjust the opacity if you want it to be more transparent, or you can rotate the image if you like. And there, of course, are keyboard shortcuts for all of these. For example, if you select the layer and you hit S, it'll just show you the scale. So you can easily adjust the scale this way. And you can also hit P and it'll show you the position controls. If you hit T, it'll show you transparency. And if you hit R, it'll show you rotation. So every asset that you use in After Effects has these transform tools, and it's something that you should know that it's always there. So now that we have our clip in its new transformed state that we want, now we need to make our still image of the background. So let's make sure that the playhead is at the beginning of the clip because that's the first frame that we want to make a still from. And now with the layer selected, we're going to go up to Composition, Save Frame As, and then File. And what this will do is it'll add it to a render queue as a Photoshop file. So you can click on this Photoshop file and you can change it to a different format if you want. You can turn it to a PNG file. You could also turn it into a JPEG. So I'm going to change mine to PNG file. So let's save it here into our media folder. So now what we can do is we can drag this PNG file into our project panel. And once it's here, we can drag the PNG beneath the video file in our composition. And you can see here that these layers work just like Photoshop. The layer at the top will always be seen on the top in the composition window here. And if I turn the video layer off, you will just see the still image of the video beneath it. So what we need to do next is just isolate the movement of the tea pouring out of the video layer above. So let's turn on the video layer again, and now we can zoom in to the tea spout using the Z key on our keyboard and zoom in to the tea. And if you press H, you can use the hand tool to reposition it in the center of the frame. Now we will use the pen tool here to begin drawing a mask around the tea. To start the mask, just click to create your first point, and then you can click again to create your first line of the mask. And if the color is too hard to see with the current video that you're working with, you can change the color of the mask. Just toggle down from the layer, and then from mask, just click on the color and choose a new color that's easy to see. So I'll choose a red color. Now continue to draw your mask. And a tip that I have is that if you click and you hold at a new point, it'll make a curved path. And this is something that you can practice and get better and better at. So I'm just going to continue to make points and draw around the liquid part here. And then to close off the mask to finish it, just click on the first point that you made so we now have our new mask. But as we play it back, you will see that the background for the most part is still, but we need to move the mask path to fit the movement of the liquid. So we need to animate it. Then from underneath mask on this layer, we need to hit the stopwatch button to begin animating the mask path, okay? And this will create our first keyframe. And now we can move our playhead and to see where we need to modify the mask. So if we start to see that the liquid moves a little bit, what we can do is we can click on mask, and then we can use the pen tool to adjust the mask path to move with the movement of the liquid. And then let's keep doing that. So let's scrub ahead and let's move the mask path again until we don't see the background photo in the shot and the path moves nicely with the liquid. So once you're done doing that, what we can do is add a little bit of feathering here so the mask is less noticeable. So now when we play it back, it's just a looping shot of liquid being poured from the tea. So if you want to add some color correction on top here or create some cool effects, what we can do is right click in the comp to create an adjustment layer. So this created an adjustment layer. Just make sure to move this adjustment layer on top of both the clips in our current composition, so that way any effects we apply to it will affect all the clips beneath it. So next, let's go up to the effects panel here, and you can search for any effects to put onto this adjustment layer. And if you do not see your effects panel, be sure to go up to Window and open it up. So for example, After Effects has a ton of free, cool, creative image presets. So from the image creative folder, I'm going to pull in any of these looks on the adjustment layer until I find one that I like the most. So I'm going to try this look here and I really like it, and it's applying the filter to both the still image as well as the video in my composition. So everything looks great, and if you want to export this as a GIF, this is how you do it. Go to File, Export, and add to Adobe Media Encoder Queue. You can also add to Render Queue, but it's easier to go to Adobe Media Encoder Queue because you can open up more settings to play around with. And just as a reminder, this will only export the render comp work area that we have selected. Now this export will appear in Adobe Media Encoder, and from format, you want to click on this. And what this will do is it will open up a new export dialog box. And if you've used Premiere Pro before, this will be familiar to you because it's the exact same one. And this is where you can select a new format, such as the animated GIF in our case. And we can also give it a new output name and save it in the correct location. And if you need to change the size of your final export, let's say you export it and it's too big of a file and you want it to be a smaller file size, you can reduce the dimensions of our GIF here from the video tab. So to do that, if you want to cut it in half in this area here next to 1920, just hit /2 to divide it in half, and then this will export now at half resolution. So then hit OK, and then be sure to hit the green play button from Encoder to start exporting. And now we have our awesome cinemagraph.
So that is my introduction to Adobe After Effects. If you have any other Adobe After Effects requests, be sure to leave a comment below. And inside of my description box just below this video, I will include a playlist to all of the Adobe After Effects tutorials I have on this channel already, including a recent one where I showed you how to edit Adobe After Effects logo opener templates, which you can get from Envato Market and Envato Elements. And I'll include a link to my recommended templates in the description box below. So that's all for this week. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys soon. Bye.